There have been many disturbing crimes committed across England in the last 150 years, some more famous than others, and some that have never been solved. However, the majority of the time, the guilty are generally caught and convicted for their crimes. Today we explore one of those convicted criminals, John Reginald Halliday Christie, aka the Rillington Place Strangler. John Christie, known as Reg to his family and friends, was born on April 8, 1899, in West Yorkshire in the UK. He was often coddled and bullied by his mother and older sisters, and alternatively, was often punished for trivial offences by his carpet designer father, Ernest John Christie. As Christie got older, many of his peers described him as an awkward lad that kept himself to himself. On the 24th of March 1911, just before Christie's 12th birthday, his grandfather, David Halliday, died aged 75. Christie had said he felt empowered and a sense of well-being came over him. A man he had once feared was now just a powerless corpse laid out in front of him. Signs of Christie's future horrific crimes were now already starting to become apparent through his ever-changing personality, and not for the better. On April 12, 1917, Christie was called up to the army to serve as an infantryman. In April 1918, the regiment was dispatched to France, and in June later that year, Christie suffered from a mustard attack, which left him partially blind and mute for the better part of 3 years. Christie had said that this is what led him to speak with a soft-spoken voice, although doctors and psychologists both suggested his soft-spoken voice was due to a psychological problem more than a physical one. Christie was later demobilised from the army in October 1922. He had a brief stint with the Royal Air Force from December 1923 to August 1924, but was later discharged. On May 10, 1920, John Christie married Ethel Simpson from Sheffield in the UK. Christie, however, had impotence problems and visited several prostitutes over the course of their marriage. They separated after just 4 years of marriage, but after a decade of being apart and Christie's frequent visits in and out of jail, they were once again reunited, this time in Notting Hill, Rillington Place, London. Over the near decade that Christie spent in and out of prison for petty crimes, including postal order theft, there was one crime that stood out from the rest, that could have been an indicator for what was to come. Christie was convicted of assaulting Maud Cole with a cricket bat, a crime which the magistrates described as a murderous attack. Christie reconciled with Ethel in 1934, and although his petty crime had come to an end, he still continued to sleep with prostitutes. Christie committed his first murder, Ruth Furist, in 1943. Ruth was an Austrian woman who worked often as a prostitute for extra money. Christie later admitted that he had strangled her with rope and placed her body under the floorboards before later burying her in his back garden. This was the start of a 10-year killing spree of 8 innocent victims. His favourite method of killing was death by strangulation, and he would sometimes commit heinous sexual acts with the naked dead bodies of his victims. In late 1949, a controversial killing of Beryl Evans and her baby daughter Geraldine was discovered in the washhouse of Rillington Place. Beryl's husband, Timothy Evans, was later convicted and hanged in 1950 for the killings of his wife and child, after he had been coerced into a false confession by London police. Christie testified against Timothy and helped to seal his fate. He was hanged in March 1950. Christie murdered his own wife, Ethel, on the 14th of December 1952 by strangulation. his favourite method of killing. He buried her under the floorboards of Rillington Place. He then went on to murder three more women between January and March of 1953. Between 1943 and 1953, Christie had committed a total of 8 murders. Ruth Furist, 21 years old, on the 24th of August, 1943. Muriel Eady, aged 31, on the 7th of October, 1944. Beryl Evans, aged 20, on the 8th of November, 1949. Geraldine Evans, aged just 13 months, on the 8th of November, 1949. Ethel Christie, aged 54, on the 12th of December, 1952. Rita Nelson, aged 25, on the 19th of January, 1953. Kathleen Maloney, aged 26, on February of 1953. The exact date is unknown. Hectorina McLennan, aged 26, on the 6th of March, 1953. Just 2 weeks after committing his last murder of Hectorina McLennan, he moved out of 10 Rillington Place and fraudulently let his flat out to a couple. The landlord visited later that evening and dismissed the couple from the flat, then going on to allow the tenant from upstairs the use of Christie's downstairs kitchen. The upstairs tenant, Beresford Brown, attempted to install brackets on the wall, and after peeling back wallpaper from the alcove in the downstairs kitchen, he discovered the bodies of McLennan, Nelson and Maloney. Christie was finally arrested for his crimes on March 31st, 1953, and when he went to trial, it took the jury only 85 minutes to deliver the verdict. Guilty. Christie was hanged on the 15th of July, 1953, at Pentonville Prison. There is no doubt that Christie could have committed far more crimes than he was convicted or accused of, but no further investigation on missing women in the area was ever made. Christie did not admit to all of his crimes, claiming he had had a nervous breakdown and his memory was hazy, but nonetheless, he was still punished. He did, however, sit with a priest moments before his hanging and was told to say the names of his victims, being advised it may help God save his soul. He repeated 6 of the 8 names, but never officially admitted to Geraldine Evans, and did not repeat his wife's name. There is no denying of the evil in this world, but always remember there is far more good. Always be kind to those who deserve it, and try not to judge with a heavy heart those that don't. Even the best of us can fall into a world of unimaginable convictions. Thank you for watching Uncertain Certainties. Please remember to like, comment, and subscribe. And don't forget to click the little bell notification to be notified of any future videos. Good morning, good evening, and good night.